17 is a combination town hall and Appleton Academy, with funds from the town and the academy. The arched window in the front and the twisted columns in the interior are believed to have been taken from the old meeting house. The red brick Matthias Wilson house at 11 Preston Hill Road was built around 1833. Next we have two pictures of the painted white brick Abel Shattuck house on Willard Road, also referred to as the Spofford house, built circa 1811. Here we have three views of the Falwell Spalding House, built around 1814 and just around the corner from the town hall, when it had a large porch on the side. Following are two pictures of the old Baptist parsonage at 183 Main Street, showing it covered with vines. It was also known as the Cragen House. It was built around 1770 as the parsonage of the Baptist Church, which at the time stood next to it. The church was moved to its present location on Main Street in 1850. This house had a nickname of the Clover Patch. The Orlando Marshall House in the center of Bank Village was built in the 1830s. The William Ainsworth House, built in 1831, also in Bank Village Center. Another view of the Ainsworth House with its front porch later removed. The Charles Barrett III House in Bank Village was built in 1830 by Charles Barrett Jr. as a wedding present for his son. The porches seen here have been removed. The Manufacturers Bank in Bank Village after it became a private residence. This building was torn down in the early 20th century. The Methodist Church, built in 1849, stood on River Road in Bank Village. It was taken down in 1926 and the materials used to build a house on the turnpike. Bridge over the Sahigan River on Old Country Road, looking towards the country club. The bridge viewed from the opposite side. Next we have two pictures of Bank Village taken from the Sahigan Country Club. View of the Sahigan River and the bridge from the center of Bank Village. From the Sahigan Country Club, we overlook Waterloo Pond with Mount Watatic in the distance. Next, we have two photographs of the original Sahigan Country Club. It was built as a residence for Jonas Wilson and was once one of the oldest houses in town. It was destroyed by fire in 1979 and the present club rebuilt on the site. The Waterloom III textile mill and dam in Bank Village was built in 1821. In 1895, the building was condemned as unsafe. Another view of the mill showing the penstock, which took water for power down to the Highbridge Mill. This was the front view of the Waterloom III mill. Next, we see the second mill at Highbridge, built after the fire of 1838, which destroyed the first mill. This structure burned in 1872, and the present mill was constructed in 1875. Built around 1765, the home of Dr. Frederick Jones was located at the intersection of Smithville and Ashby Roads. He practiced medicine in the area for some 50 years. Furnace Brook Falls, just off the turnpike near Tenney Road. The high rock on Furnace Brook behind Appleton Manor. View of the bridge in Smith Village, looking towards the flagpole. The bridge over the river in Smith Village, the Hildreth House, can be seen to the right. A close-up view of the Hildreth House. Perry Place near Gibson Four Corners. The Perry Place and family. The following 11 photographs are from the Gibson Village area, on or near Ashby Road. First, we have two views of Gibson Pond. The second is labeled Balch Pond, as the Balch family had a home and sawmill in the vicinity. The Balch Dam. Here we have two pictures of the old bridge on Ashby Road, which crossed the stream from Gibson Pond. Just up the road on the right is Willard Road. And this picture is looking toward the Congregational Church. Next, we have two views of the stream as it flows toward River Road. This stream is actually named the North Branch of the Sahegan River. Next, we have three photographs of the Willow Arch on River Road. The pictures were taken from the vicinity of Gibson Four Corners. Continuing along the river road towards Bank Village. Following are two photographs of the high bridge over the Sahigan River as seen from the water's edge. It was built in 1817 and still in use today. View of Whittemore Hill. Looking west from Whittemore Hill, the next six postcards are unidentified scenes in New Ipswich. The first two are views with Mount Watatic in the distance. This one is labeled Just Daisies. This is called On the Highway. This postcard reads, The Old Homestead. This is a view of Kidder Mountain. The William Locke family and homestead. Next, we have four photographs near the Fred Gibson place in Gibson Village. This is Willard Road going towards the Congregational Church. Our last series of postcards are of Wapak Lodge. It was located where the Wapak Trail crosses the turnpike to the west of town near the windblown cross-country ski area. It burned down in the early 1990s. we're looking north from the Wapak. In our last picture is a view of Mount Monadnock. The following 82 photographs were taken from the Charles A. Plumer albums. Mr. Plumer was a Boston photographer who visited New Ipswich over several years. When he stayed in New Ipswich, he stayed at the Little Red House at the base of Porter Hill Road. Many of his photographs are in color. The color process was referred to as tinting and was done by hand by a colorist employed by Mr. Plumer. The first 44 pictures are from album number 1 and the balance from album number 2. All photographs were taken between 1907 and 1914, except where noted. They were donated to the Historical Society by Mr. Plummer's heirs and placed in these albums by Hazel Balch Moore, our town historian. Our first two pictures are of the King Road birches near Appleton Academy. Appleton Academy was established in 1789 as the second academy in the state, being preceded by Phillips Academy in Exeter by 5 years. Here we have the Reverend Lee House, built around 1828 and located near the Appleton campus. On the opposite side of the campus, we have the Harris Barr Homestead, which was built in 1768. The largest willow tree in New Hampshire at the time was the veteran willow located on the Barr Estate. It was cut down in 1923 due to storm damage. The side view of the Barr home is seen from the willows. Next, we move inside to the living room of the Barr home. Upstairs to a bedroom. Guest room. An additional view of the guest room. Our next three pictures are of the public library. It was built in 1895 largely through the efforts of Miss Caroline Frances Barr, whose funeral was actually held here. The addition in the rear was added in 1902. following are three photographs of the French landscape wallpaper entitled Monuments of Paris that once existed in the parlor of the Appleton Inn. It was imported by Samuel Appleton for his sister, Mrs. Barrett, who lived in the house before 1845. The old corner store was built by Samuel Batchelder Jr. in 1813. The post office was located here from 1861 to 1933. It was torn down in 1946. The old stage tavern was built by Isaiah Kidder in 1808. At the time of this photo, it was operated by Peter Clark as Clark's Hotel. Next, we have two pictures of the wallpaper in the Samuel Batchelder Jr. house, built by Samuel Batchelder in 1813. This is currently known as Glavy Antiques. This is the first academy building now occupied as a private dwelling. It was built in 1789 and located on the left as you turn from the turnpike onto Porter Hill Road. The next series of three photos are of the Henry T. Champney property on Porter Hill Road, built around 1785 and referred to as the Maples by the Champneys. Henry had made a fortune in New York in the patent medicine business. The grounds were beautifully landscaped, with paved paths through the garden at a time when streets of town were not yet paved. The exact location of our next picture is unknown. It's labeled the Birch Path on the way to the Starch Mill. The Starch Mill was located on Furnace Brook just off what is now called Thayer Road. Next we have four pictures from the Deacon Isaac Appleton Homestead on Appleton Road. This home was built in 1756. Here we have the front entryway and stairway. The upper west room, and the old English wallpaper in the upper east room. The old Lover's Lane is described in the album as having started on the back road near Grace Smith's and coming out near Tricknick Mill. It is unknown at this time where Grace Smith lived. The following picture is labeled the Birch Road at Bonnie Bray, which was the nickname for the summer home of Ralph Parker, just off of Temple Road. The Pratt or Adams House was at the end of Tenney Road, near the present ambulance building. It was built as a blockhouse as a defense from Indians by Mr. Adams, known to most as the Matty Kangas Farm. This bridge on the turnpike crossed Furnace Brook just below the Pratt Farm at the intersection of what is presently named Tenney Road. The Furnace Brook Falls is located just downstream of this same area. Here's a familiar view of the bridge crossing the Sahigan on Old Country Road.
view from Bank Village of the Sahegan River and Waterloo Pond. A view of Waterloo Pond with Mount Wartatic in the distance from the old country road. In this view from the Sahegan Country Club, note the old Congregational Church in the distance to the right. The Sahegan Country Club was originally built as the home of Jonas Wilson in the 18th century. The porch was added after it became a clubhouse. It burned down in 1979 and the present building was constructed on the same site. In this view from the country club, note that the Congregational Church is no longer in the picture, as it had since burned down. This photo of Waterloo Pond is titled The Sahegan River and Grandpa Thayer's Island. The next two photographs are from Ed Marshall's cabin overlooking the Sahegan. Note the bridge can be seen in the second photo. This concludes album number one. We will now begin album number two. Our next three pictures are of the Champney Preston House across from the Baptist Church. The Preston Elm is the focus of the third photograph. Next, we have three photographs of the Pritchard Clark home on the corner of Main Street and Porter Hill Road, also known as the Ralph Taylor home, and more recently as the home of the Durfee family. This picture was taken in 1889. Shown next on Main Street is the Peter Clark home on the left and the former historical building on the right. The former historical building is generally known today as Pearl Thompson's. Next, we look across the meadow from the same location, noting the Baptist Church and Barr and Lee homes. And here is a better view of the former historical building. The Stratton House on Porter Hill Road was built about 1769. This photo was taken in 1889. The home is no longer there. A view of Porter Hill Road. The house with the porch is no longer there.